Is the wisdom tooth surgery dangerous? Over the years, we heard many news of patients dying on a dental chair during or after the wisdom tooth surgery. But is it really that dangerous? I'm Dr. Scott Lee, your friendly neighborhood dentist. Let me go through with you like what you will be expecting before and during a wisdom tooth surgery, and you decide yourself whether it's dangerous. Be it a general dentist or a specialist, in order to know your current health status, the condition of a wisdom tooth, they ask you for medical history to look out for any indications or contraindications that influence the removal or the retention of the wisdom tooth. The social history, if you have any limited access to routine medical care or long periods away from civilization, and the decision may favor a more interventional prophylactic approach. They ask you some dental history for anxiety in adults can be accessed for sedation needs. The age carries the highest risk for complication after the surgery. And the dentist will also do some clinical examination to see if the tooth is out, test the visibility of the tooth inside the mouth in relation to surrounding bone, gums and teeth, any infection surrounding it or any decay to the adjacent tooth, and also to do some appropriate radiological investigation, which is the x-ray, reading in 2D or even 3D to see the tooth properly inside the bone. So with the x-ray, the dentist can determine the difficulty level of the surgery and advise you accordingly. And on case-to-case basis, the wisdom tooth surgery can be done under the three methods. First is to giving the local numbing agent, which is the injection. To numb the gums, teeth, as well as the bone. And second is through sedation. It's by taking medication or inhaling laughing gas, which is the nitrous oxide, or injecting drugs inside your veins, make you sedated and comfortable during the surgery. And the third method is to do the wisdom tooth surgery under general anesthesia. Usually this is indicated especially when the surgery is complicated or lengthy. Once the tooth is numb, the dentist will give a cut to the gum to expose the bone surrounding the tooth. And the dentist will remove some bone surrounding the wisdom tooth to help in the removal of the wisdom tooth. Then the dentist may remove the tooth manually or split the tooth into small pieces before removing them. At the end of the treatment, once the tooth is out, the wound is being cleaned and make sure there's no root piece left inside and the bleeding has stopped. Only then the dentist will send you back. And that's all for the day. And on the next session, we'll be talking on the 4-6 delay and the 6 complications right after the wisdom tooth surgery. Do stay tuned. See you soon.